We want to determine if each table represents a linear function, exponential function, or neither. Remember, a linear function fits the form f of x equals mx plus b. So if x is increasing by a constant amount, the function values will have a common difference. An exponential function fits the form f of x equals a times b raised to the power of x. So as x increases by a constant amount, the function values would have a common ratio. So let's look at our tables and see if we can recognize the pattern. Notice in all the tables, x is increasing by a constant amount, in this case 1. So now we'll analyze the function values. Looking at this first table, the first function value is negative 6, the second is negative 1, the third is positive 4, and the fourth is positive 9. It's usually easiest to see if a table is linear, so let's see if these function values have a common difference. So if we take negative 1 and subtract negative 6, that would be negative 1 plus 6, or positive 5, which is telling us if this is linear, we're adding 5 to each function value. Let's see if that's true. Negative 6 plus 5 is negative 1. Negative 1 plus 5 is positive 4. And 4 plus 5 is 9. Therefore, all these function values do have a common difference of 5, which means it's a linear function. Of course, we could also graph these points to see if it's linear, which we'll do at the very end. Looking at our second table, the first function value is 50, the second is 20, the third is 8, and the fourth is 3.2. To check to see if it's linear, we'll find the difference between the first two function values. Well, 20 minus 50 is equal to negative 30, which means if it's linear, the pattern would have to be subtracting 30 each time. But we can quickly see that 20 minus 30 is not 8, so it cannot be linear. So now we'll test to see if it's exponential. If it's exponential, we'd be multiplying by the same value each time, which is hard to tell, and that's why if it's exponential, we can test to see if we have a common ratio. So now we'll find the ratio of 20 to 50, which is equal to 2/5, or 0.4. So if it's exponential, that means we're multiplying by 0.4 each time. Well, 50 times 0.4 is equal to 20, and 20 times 0.4 is equal to 8, and 8 times 0.4 is equal to 3.2. Therefore, these function values have the common ratio of 0.4, or 2/5, and therefore this table represents an exponential function. Moving on to our last table, we have a function value of 7, and then 4, and then 3, and then 4 again. To test to see if it's linear, notice how to go from 7 to 4, we'd have to subtract 3 or add negative 3, but 4 minus 3 does not equal 3, so it can't be linear. So now we'll test to see if it's exponential. Again, it's difficult to determine what times 7 would give us 4, so we'll find the ratio of 4 to 7, which of course is just 4/7. So if this is exponential, then 4 times 4/7 must be equal to 3, which it's not. Which means this also cannot be exponential. So if it's not linear and it's not exponential, that means it's neither. To double check our work, it might be helpful to also look at these points on the coordinate plane. So here's our first table, which we said was linear. And notice how we could draw a line through these four points. Here's the second table, and notice how it does look like it behaves like an exponential function. In this case, it would be exponential decay. And then for our last table, notice how it's not linear or exponential, and that's why it was neither. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.